Hello, today we'll be going through the Tinkerine Suite tutorial. Tinkerine Suite is an easy to use software program that is packed with useful features for getting your 3D files ready for printing. If you haven't done so already, visit tinkerine.com/tinkerine-suite to download the newest version from our website. After installation, launch Tinkerine Suite. You'll see the slice settings on top and a visual representation of the printer's build area in the middle of the screen. Depending on which Tinkerine 3D printer you're using, there are presets for each under the printer selection tab. Now let's get started. Click on the import button on the top bar and select a STL model to bring in. Since the imported gem model is on its side, let's first use the rotational tool to flip it upright so we are printing with the flat face on the bottom. The rotational tool will allow you to rotate the model on the X, Y, and Z axis. Holding the shift key while rotating will allow you to rotate in 45 degree increments. To adjust the size of your model, there are a couple ways to do so. The first way is to click and drag the freescaling node attached to a model. If you're looking for a more precise way, use the dialog box on the bottom to enter a percentage. If we enter 50 here, the model will scale to 50% of its original size. If you want a specific length on the axis, you can also directly input the values into the X, Y, and Z axis dialog boxes. To duplicate your model, click on the Duplicate button on the toolbar, and within the dialog box, enter the number of additional copies you wish to have. You can freely move around the model on the build area. If you want to center the model afterwards, you can use the Center tool. If you don't remember what you changed, you can always press the Reset tool to reset all positions, scaling, rotating to the imported state. Once you finish making adjustments to the model, move on to the printing settings located beside the import button. First off, we have the printing resolution. Choosing between low, medium, and high will affect the thickness of each printer layer. Let's take a look at a comparison photo. Selecting low will print each layer at 300 micron or 0.3 millimeters. While the visibility of each layer is more apparent on the outer shell, this will allow your print to finish faster. The medium settings will print your model at 200 micron or 0.2 millimeter. This is the default setting and it has a good balance between speed and surface finish. Selecting high will print each layer at 100 micron or 0.1 millimeter. While this is half the layer thickness of compared to the medium, the print will also take roughly double the amount of time to complete. The next option on the settings menu is the infill selection. This setting allows you to adjust the density of the internal structure within the model. Let's go ahead and look at the available options. Choosing hollow will remove any support structure within the model. This is great for cutting down on print time for models that don't have a roof feature that require to be supported. Selecting sparse will generate an even distribution of internal structures within the model. This will be the go-to options for the majority of prints that you do. Selecting the dense option will generate a large amount of internal structure within the model. While this is great for creating sturdy prints, it would add to film usage and total print time. Let's take a look at the wall selection menu. Use the wall tool to adjust the thickness of your model's exterior surface. Depending on the number of walls you select, each would add the respective amount of layers that make up the outer surface. Last, we have the support tool. Turning on the support option will generate printed supporting structure for overhanging parts of the model. This allows parts of the model that are suspending in mid-air to print out successfully. After the print is complete, the supporting structures can be peeled away by hand or a pair of pliers. After adjusting the modification and slicing settings, we are ready to press slice. When you press slice, Tinkerine Suite will process your model for 3D printing. Once Tinkerine Suite is done slicing your model, you'll see the print preview for your model along with other information. The estimated print time for your model, the amount of filament used in grams, the layer preview slider, which allows you to look at each layer. Next to it, you'll have the ability to add pauses during the print at specific layers. And you have edit to return to modifying your settings. Last of all, save for print to export the file to a SD card or your computer. Once you have saved the file onto your SD card, you're ready to print your file. Tinkerine Suite also has an advanced setting menu for users who like to change more settings for their model. Go to the Advanced tab and turn on the Advanced setting. Now you will see more options. You can choose to print your model at an ultra resolution now. Ultra resolution will print at 50 microns, which is 0.05 millimeters. Support option will now let you choose between off, exterior, and full. Off means no support will be generated. Exterior means generating support from the print surface only. And full means generating support anywhere the model needs it, even on the print itself. You can also adjust your filament diameter now. Measure your filament diameter and then input it here for the best output. Next, you can adjust the print speed for your model as well. Last but not least, the temperature for your print. The recommended temperature for Tinkerine PLA filament is between 215 to 220 degrees Celsius. Experiment with what works best for your printer and 3D model. If you're unsure on what you have changed, you can always click Reset All Slice Settings to bring all the settings back to default. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, keep on printing.